Jesus loves you, children, 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 Jesus loves you. Okay, shall we pray? Our Heavenly Father, we thank you, we bless you, we exalt thy name. Thank you for a beautiful Sunday. Thank you for life. Thank you, God, for the privilege to be alive, hale and hearty. We thank you for our parents. Thank you for our pastors. We thank you for our church. Father, be thou exalted in Jesus' name. Thank you for yet another Sunday, O God. Come and learn at your feet, O God. We say, be thou exalted in Jesus' name. Father, we pray, O God, as we start today's Sunday, we pray that in your mercy, O God, come and be with us, O God. Please take absolute control of today's service, O God. And at the end, O God, may we have full cause to give glory to your name. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen.
Children, praise the Lord. Praise, 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 praise the Lord. Are you happy to be in church today?
Yes.
Can we just close our eyes and pray? Father, we thank you for today. We bless your name. We give you all the praise and all the glory, Father, Lord, for the salvation of our soul and for keeping us alive to this day, Father, for taking away the pandemic from our lives and our nations in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May your name be praised in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you for another beautiful Sunday morning. We ask that, Father, today you will, by your Holy Spirit, come and minister to us and bless us and teach us your word in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Please bless our mommies and our dads and our pastors in Jesus' name.
Amen.
All over the world, Father, please save their souls in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Oh, Father, let it be well with every one of us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen.
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Okay, children, today we are talking about counsel the sheep. Somebody say counsel the sheep.
Counsel the sheep.
What does the word counsel mean?
Advice.
Counsel means to give
advice.
Now, is it possible for us to receive good and bad advice?
Yes.
So, which one should we choose?
good
advice, isn't it?
Yes.
Bad advice will normally lead us to trouble. God will not allow us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So our memory verse is from Proverbs 11:14. Say it.
Proverbs 11:14.
And it says, where no counsel is, say it.
Where no counsel is,
the people fall.
But
in the multitude of counselors, there is safety. What does it mean? This memory verse. Where no counsel is, the people fall. But in the multitude of counselors, there is safety. What do you understand?
It means that when there is nobody to give advice, nobody knows what to do.
Good advice. Not advice, so not ordinary advice. Not any
good advice.
Good advice. Good. What does it mean? What do you understand, Gumi?
It means that when there's no good advice, people fall. But when there's good advice,
people will stand. There'll be safety. Good. Yes. Good. Daniel, what do you understand?
It means when there's no advice to give you a good advice, take a wrong decision. And you get into trouble.
Praise the Lord. Clap for yourself. When there is no good advisor to give you good advice, you may end up taking the wrong decision. So what we are going to be praying about in our lives, that God should always give us good people around us who are going to give us good advice, good counselors. Okay, so our story today, Bible text, is taken from a story of a young man. 1 Kings 12:1-12. 1 Kings 12. Verses 1-12. We will not read it because of our time, but going to just tell you the story. It's the story of King Solomon's son. His name is Rehoboam. When King Solomon died, his first son was supposed to take over. So this Rehoboam, when they gathered together to come and make him king, the people around him told him, "Oh king, your father did not treat us well when he was alive. Please, we ask you to treat us well so that we can serve you." So he said to them, "Give me 3 days and I will give you an answer." So he went to the people who were ruling with his father, the elders, and asked them, "See what all these people have come to ask me. What should I do?" They said, "Please honor them, serve them, love them. They will obey you. They will serve you better. Your father did very, very bad things to them, made their yoke very heavy. So they are asking you to calm down on them. Don't do as hard as your father was. Don't put all those tax on them." And he said, "Okay, thank you for your advice." He went to another group of people, this time around, his age mates. He now asked them, "What do I do in this circumstance?" They say, "Tell them that your yoke will be harder than your father's own." He said, "Okay, thank you." He now went to the people that asked him a question after 3 days, and he said to them, "What my father did to you, I'm going to do worse." So when you get home, please read the whole of that scripture. 1 Kings 12. Verse 1-33, you will see the story, the whole thing that happened. When a man takes bad counsel, he always ends up in trouble. May that not be our portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We have said that counsel means to give advice. And our memory verse said, when we have plenty of counselors, good counselors, we can be in safety. Who and who should we receive counsel from?
God and Jesus.
Yes.
Our parents.
Yes.
Good friends.
Yes. What about teachers? Our teachers, both in the church and in the school.
Our pastors.
Clap for all of you. This is a wonderful class. We can receive good advice from our uncles, aunties, but they must be people who honor God so that they don't give us wrong counsel. Okay. So, what are the kinds of areas we can receive advice? What are the areas you can receive advice? When you want to go to school now, you have 3 schools in your area, and you like them. How do you choose the school to go to? I'm giving you.
You ask God.
Good. What about those that are
good? I ask God which is the right one for me.
Which is the right one for you to do? Good. What about those that want to marry? Should they not ask God?
They should ask God.
Now.
If it's the right man or
what about
the
what
right
you, if it's the right man or the right? I like that. If it is the right man or the right place. What about those that want to go have a job? Want to go and apply for work?
You ask God.
You also ask God. Is that the right job for me? Or you want to go to university? You ask God, which university, which course am I going to study? Because you can go to the wrong place. Or you can go to a place where God will not send you. And then, God forbid, there will be trouble. Okay, what about those that want to travel? They want to travel. You want to go to America. I mean, where do you want to go to? London. Where do you want to go to?
Your grandma
will
take you to
West
America.
Eh? Your grandma? So if your grandma is taking you to America, should you ask God or grandma's word is final?
We'll ask God.
You also ask God. Okay, so what about in choosing our friends? Daniel, is there anyone that you have had as a friend in your class, your schoolmate, and you ask God? Did you ask God? Yes? Did you ask God about your friends? Did you ask God? Did you ask your mommy and daddy about your friends?
Yes, I told my mommy about my friends.
You told your mommy about your friends. What about you? You told her about your friends. And she's okay with them.
Yes.
So we must learn to listen to our parents and our older ones because of the wrong decisions we can easily make without knowing. You know they are older, so they see more than us, okay? Mm-hmm. So from now on, we must learn to ask God and ask our mommies and dad, and then pastors and our teachers for a good counsel. So before we close, we're going to have our activity, and that activity is to memorize Psalm 1. So we're going to memorize Psalm 1. That's our activity for this week. But let me quickly read it for you. Psalm 1 verse 1 to 6. It's only 6 verses, so it's easy. Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, in his law doth he meditate day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he doeth shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff, which the wind driveth away. Therefore the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked shall perish. So we see that good counsel will lead us to righteousness and make us like a tree planted by rivers or water. But bad counsel will make us like chaff, and it will be blown away. So children, before we round up, let us close our eyes and pray. Father, we want to thank you for today. We bless your name for teaching us, O God Almighty, how to receive counsel, to stay with a counsel that will give us good direction in life. Father, may your name be praised in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We pray that from now on we'll receive good counsel from our parents, from our teachers, from our pastors, from people who are our friends, and they will give us good counsel in Jesus' name.
Amen.
That we will not make mistakes or run into any kind of bad decision in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, Lord, we ourselves will not be bad counselors in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We will not teach other people the wrong things to do in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, we say thank you, God. Father, this week, O God, please help us, O Lord. Direct us and let your Holy Spirit guide our hearts in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we are prayed.
Amen. Amen.
Hello, children. It's offering time, blessing time. So let's raise an offering unto God. You can tell mommy to give you offering. So let's put our offerings together and let us pray. You can raise it up as we pray. Father, in Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you for all that you've done for us. Thank you for providing for us, oh God. Accept our offering in Jesus' name. We pray you bless us the more in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because you have answered our prayers. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Yeah, shall we look up and say bye-bye to our friends?
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.